Hello everyone. So I'll be telling about the critical reasoning and general intelligence part of your PGCET. So basically, before telling about what in detail we're doing in this subject, so let me give you a gist on the syllabus part of it. So the first thing is the syllabus contains the series and the arithmetic reasoning, the odd one outs. A few puzzles will also be there, and aptitude kind of questions and analogy also. So I will kind of promise you to keep this very interesting, because this part of your PGCET paper is quite easy, so you can crack and clear it very well. So and I'll be telling you also the methods to like solve it faster with your time. Let's go detail into the syllabus part. So first, series. So series meaning you'll have the number series, which means like suppose I'm giving you a very easier number series like 1, 2, 3, -5, 6. So obviously you can fill it with 4. So that will be the series. So that's a like complete number series. So it can be like squares or the square roots or multiplication like that. Like continuous series will be there. You have to fill up the gaps. We have alphabetic series also. Alphabetic series includes like complete alphabets like A, B, C, D. And here decoding will be there. Decoding meaning if suppose A, B, C, D, E is equal to happy, so what will the rest be? So I'll be telling you how to decode this. So the alphabets will also have some kind of numbers. So like A is 1, B is 2, Z is 26. Such a pattern. So all of this will be told in detail. And you have alphanumeric. So we know what is the number series and what is alphabet series. So alphanumeric is like the combination of these both, the number and alphabet. So you have both alphabets as well as the numbers in this series. Now we have mixed series. Mixed series meaning you can have, okay, mixed series and correspondence series is kind of similar. Like you will have numbers as well as alphabets, as well as letters, and you will have mixture of all of these. So that's these kind of series. And letter series is like, it includes alphabets obviously, but it's going to look like AABBCC and then BBCCAA. So like kind of like that, like mixture of the alphabets. So the PGCET university will give us this kind of mixtures. So it will be easier. So I will make it as much as simple, and you can clear it. So I'll be helping you in that too. And arithmetic reasoning. Okay, so arithmetic reasoning is like you will have to assume the things with equations like X or Y equations. So and here arithmetic reason, it takes a lot of time, so you have to manage the time too, and solving it quicker will make it beneficial. Like the questions asked here will be related to the age, and you have to calculate the fare, that is the cost of it. Completely equation based only questions. So the X is so much, what is Y, or Y so much, what is the X. Age related questions are like high possibility that you will get like that, like dad's age is 1x times of the son's age, or 10x times of the son's age, etc. That kind of arithmetic questions you will get. Next we have odd one outs. Okay, odd one outs is very simple. You shouldn't waste the time here, like taking 2 or 3 seconds is max for this question. So here odd one outs, you will have kind of series, like we study series like that, we'll have 4 options. So out of these, you have to select the odd one. Like if suppose 3 fruits are given 1 vegetable, so what's the odd one? That's the kind of thing. Okay, so it won't be that simple also. I'll give you an example. Like for months, if they ask January, March, May, and you have February, so here the odd one out will be February, because the number of days in the month will be less. So that kind of difference will be given in 1 and 3:1 will be the ratio actually here, so that you can find the odd one out. So the kind of questions will be relating to mostly the patterns, some kind of patterns, or it might be the months, like I gave an example right now. And it can also be like numbers, like if even numbers are given and one odd one is given, like that's the kind of things you have to find. And it can be series, like series I already told, like what kind of series can be asked. It can be letters or alphabets, or it can be numbers, or it can be mixed also. So that kind of series. And squares, the square roots, like if suppose 3 square is 9, 9 square is 81, like that kind of even number square roots are given and odd number square roots are given. So if there's 3 to 1 ratio, then the one should be the odd one out, that kind of questions. So odd one out also will be taken into the portion. And we have puzzles. This is the most interesting part in your PGCET paper, I can tell you. So it can be like blood relations, like your what is your father's sister called, that kind of. So here in blood relations, sometimes you will have to make the graph, I mean the chart. Like in the question, it will be given A's mother is so and so, and A has a sister, A has a daughter. So what is A's daughter? So that kind of mixtures will be given. So you cannot assume the questions. Like I'm dictating it to you, your mind won't flash. So you have to make a chart kind of, and I'll be teaching you how to make that simple too. So blood relations is relating to that. It might be also relating to your maternal blood relationship or paternal blood relationship. So I'll explain what are people called. Like in English, it will be more, I mean, to remember it will be little hard, but when you know the easier ways to remember it, it will be very easier for you too. Next, we have seating arrangements. Seating arrangements is like if the it says that A is sitting next to B, and some kind of question will be given. So in this puzzle, it will be mainly like linear or circular or polygon. So it might be in a straight line or it might be in a circular way, like surrounded, or it can be in a polygon shape also. So these are the possibilities of the seating arrangement. We have to find where, who is sitting next to whom, like if A is sitting next to B or C is sitting next to B, that kind of puzzles will also be given. And direction is also very easy. Here also you shouldn't spend much time. Like blood relations, direction test also you have to write the chart, meaning making the chart will make you easier. Like direction based questions, I'll give you an example. They'll say A moves towards the north, then turns towards the east and towards the west, etc, etc, etc. So that kind of directions will be given. We have to draw a flow chart kind of. Okay, so here the main thing is they'll ask you where is he starting from or where is he ending, or if he moves towards the north and then moves west, like that, northwest or southwest or northeast, southeast, that kind of directions also will be asked. So maximum possibility is these kind of questions in direction two. And we have matrix reasoning. Matrix reasoning will be, you will get a matrix wherein you will have alphabets and numbers too. There will be some missing figures in the matrix. So you have to recognize if it's an alphabet or number and specifically write. So don't worry, all of these will have four options. So just find the nearby option and I'll teach you the methods also and how to not waste time in this. That's most important in PGCET paper. Okay, next is aptitude test. In aptitude test, you have mainly syllogisms, like kind of you'll have two statements and two conclusions. Like if suppose, I'll give you an example of two statements and two conclusions using a Venn diagram. So the circle you can see here, this is the population. Okay, so it says that the entire population is there. So draw Venn diagrams in this case. Out of that population, some are boys. Okay, so why it is denoted with boys? Out of the same population, some are girls. Okay, so this is how you draw the Venn diagram. So Venn diagrams can be, I mean, it can be like some of the population or part of the population. So it depends. The Venn diagrams vary. So I cannot tell you it will be the same for everything, but I can give you different patterns of it so that you'll understand how to do that kind of problems. Okay, so that's one example of aptitude kind of test. And now a completion of figure also I'll tell you. So in the completion of figure, so you can see here I've given an example of a question there. So they'll be given one figure and one missing figure is there so that you have to complete the figure. So options will be given. Here the options look very similar to each other. So if you can see here, the four options are looking very similar to each other. But only when you imagine and put the figure there, you'll get a right answer. So I'll tell you how to get it also. Here the answer will be C, because as you can see, A is just similar to C. But here in A, you can see the edges near the circle. The difference you can make out. So that's how you have to recognize. So because it's just a introduction session, a kind of webinar, so I'm just giving you a gist of it. Otherwise, I would have told about this in detail. So I'll be taking about this, don't worry, I'll be telling about it. And I'll be making you solve few problems too. So that's about aptitude. That's how things happen in aptitude. Next we have analogy. So analogy is like quick, like it's a part of English actually. So here we'll have some kinds of tools and objects. Like example is pen, write, eraser, dash. Okay, so that's the thing. So what's pen doing? Pen is going to write, meaning using the pen to write. So why using the eraser or the rubber? Why using it? To erase. So that options will be given, four options. It might look similar, but recognizing it is the point here. So that kind of questions in the analogy. And the synonyms also will be given. Synonyms are like meanings. Meaning if suppose so the synonym of beautiful can be pretty or attractive or good looking. So it's just like samanarthaka pada we tell in Kannada. So it's just like that, like making it something similar to it. So it might not be exactly the same meaning, but it's kind of similar, right? Like you can call somebody, you look beautiful. So what's the synonym for beautiful? You can use pretty, or you can use handsome or nice looking, good looking. All of these are synonyms. So that's an example. And one more thing. Just the opposite of the synonym is called antonym. So antonym of beautiful, if we can tell, we can call them ugly. Right, understood. So it's like synonyms and antonyms kind of questions also will come. It'll be very easy to understand. It's basic English, actually. It won't be in detail, but you can do it very quickly also. And you'll have cause and effect. Like if suppose a flood will lead to damage, what will sun lead to? Or what will no rainfall lead to? Drought or something like that. The cause and effect relationship also will be given in analogy kind of questions. Okay, I hope you understood what all of this is. So I'll be telling you again. So we have analogy kind of questions, aptitude based questions, and you have puzzles, very easier, very interesting too. You have odd one out kind of questions. You have the arithmetic reasoning questions too. You have series based questions, and that's it. So it's simple. So we'll get into detail when we start with the classes.